I don't know how I let it get this bad. Try not to judge me too much. This is embarrassing to show what's become of this room. I've had a very busy couple of weeks and it's just piled up. I've had gear going in and out of the room, finishing a job, just rushing to get stuff done, and this place has just turned into a state. So I also had a film set up in here for one of the previous videos, so that didn't help because I had to basically turn the entire room upside down. And then I just didn't really clean it. You know, just got, I'll do it tomorrow. And now here we are, living in a mess. However, the first thing that we're gonna be doing today is cleaning this up, cleaning this whole of a room. On top of that, I also want to redesign this workspace. Working in this kind of mess is extremely bad for your head. You know, it kills my motivation, and it's very hard as a creator to work in something like this. And time just doesn't hang around for anyone, so past couple of weeks have been a downward spiral, to say the least, in the room like this. But we're sorting it out today. I have a vision in my head. I want to get the vision out of my head of how I want this space set up. I want to have it a bit more minimal so I can use different backgrounds in any future videos that I do use. You know, I'm just getting a lot of the crap out of here. So I'm gonna be employing the skills of my father to help with the handyman stuff. We're actually building a new benchtop, desktop, making that look a little bit nicer, and overall just making a space that's better to work in. I spend a lot of my time in this office, whether it's editing for the stuff on my channel or even just work for clients. So that I've never really liked the background that much for the videos that I've been doing. It's just sort of annoyed me with that black curtain on the wall, but it served a purpose for a time. But now, thought I'd make a video out of this, bring you along for the ride, bring you along and give you a little before and after. I'm sorry that I had to show you what it currently looks like, but today's gonna give me the chance to make this more appealing for the viewers, but also just for me when I'm working in the office. So let's run you through my thoughts. Put the place up. As I said, I wanted to make a nice wooden tabletop. It's just gonna fit over the current desk, so we're not building a whole new bench top. But as I mentioned, we're gonna be employing the skills of my dad once again, just to help out with the handyman part of the job. Let's give him a call and see if he's ready to come up and be put to work. Are you ready to get to work?
I don't know.
I require your assistance once again. We're building bench tops today. We're just, you know, we're just making motivational and creative workspaces.
Sure.
I'll see you when you get here.
Okay, see ya.
Bye. Hiccups of some sort, and the desktop took the entire day to do, so we made the entire thing only to find out when we put it on top of the current desk that it didn't fit, and it was on a really, really bad wonky angle, so we had to crack all the glue and basically start from scratch. But it's done now. It's probably not going to get stained today. It's getting sanded back, and the glue, the new glue, has to dry, so I need to start bringing everything back into the room. And the shelves are probably not going to go up today. That's gonna have to be a job for tomorrow. And I also need to try and find a way of hiding this lovely hole in the wall, but I'll figure that out later. I'm gonna get onto the vacuuming and just getting the rest of this crap out of here. I'm running out of time as usual. The light's leaving me, it's fading, but we're gonna have to pick the rest of this up tomorrow. However, I wanted to show you the desk and how that's turned out so far. Obviously, it still needs to get the nice dark stain that's gonna be similar to this color here. And then I haven't decided what it's gonna be, but I'm gonna be spray painting either my logo or my crest, family crest like this, into the middle in white spray paint, obviously with a dark stain, and the white spray is gonna look quite good. So, got my gear is gonna be stored over here, as you can see. I've also got it as like a flat lay unboxing kind of area. Also just wanna have somewhere to put all my stuff. Never know when you're gonna need a keg. Could come in handy one day, you know? But I'm calling it for a night, so we'll pick this up in the morning. I've had a bit of a late start this morning, and halfway through unpacking my shelves, I've noticed that they don't actually come with any brackets to mount them on the wall. So I've gone onto the website that I bought them off. I need to find the tiniest little print at the very bottom that they're sold separately. However, it's kind of worked out because I hated the ones that they're supposed to come with. I've just had a look and I thought they were invisible shelves, but they're not. They actually have to have some sort of bracket that goes on there, and they were horrendous. So I'm gonna go to Bunnings and get my own. Gonna go get some decor for the room as well, some plants and stuff like that. As you can probably hear, the reverb and the echo in this room is terrible, so I need to find a way of fixing that as well. But it's starting to come together, and the desk is getting stained today, so I'm gonna be doing that very soon. As usual, I'm running behind because I was editing the previous video to try and keep up with my schedule. I've got heaps to do still, as you can see, so I'm gonna try and get it all done today and hopefully show you the finished product. So let's get into it. So it's a million degrees today and I'm dying in this tiny little room with all the heat. But we're putting the shelves up. Now, I had to get a second opinion because these are running all up and down the wall, and I'm putting shelves up along here and here. I'm not an electrician, I don't know how these have been installed, so I want to make sure that I don't, you know, drill into one of those, because that's not really going to end very well. Shelves went up successfully without any electrocutions, which is good. Everything in this house pretty much wires back to that one little electrical box, so I just wanted to make sure I wasn't going to drill into one of those cables and have bad outcomes, obviously. I feel like I didn't get that much done today, but I spent a lot of the day running around, getting little bits and pieces for the office, for the studio. I haven't decided what I want to call it yet, but I still got the desk stained. That's now drying. I can't put anything heavy on it just yet. Obviously, I've got my gear all set up behind this camera right now, and I've still got to have microphone, boom mics and cameras, and decide which backdrops and angles that I want to film from in here. But I'm feeling a lot better about it as it is now compared to the start. Anyway, I'm going to show you around a little bit, just show you what else we have to go still as well. As I said, the shelves went up. This wasn't the initial plan that I had for the shelves. I was supposed to have the big shelf here, another one there, another one there, but I'm quite happy with how it turned out in terms of the corner shelf and this one off to the side a little bit here, because this is gonna be the main backdrop to a lot of the videos that I do in here. Very undecided what I'm gonna be doing with this area. I do need to fit a big black egg chair in here somewhere as well, so that might move over. Chair go in the corner, that might move over here a little bit. I'm really happy with the way that that turned out in terms of the color of the stain. It's quite hard to see in this light, and I will show you better when we do go and do a final walkthrough. But in terms of refurbishing an old desk, that worked out really well. As I said, I like my whiskey, so I've got a lot of my expensive whiskeys in this cabinet over here. There'll be some lights inside there, lighting up those and making them look all nice and tasty. Gear and props and everything else is gonna be stored under there for once, which is gonna be great because it's gonna be nice and neat and tidy for once. So that's a recap of the thoughts going on in my head in less than 60 seconds. Now the whole point behind this room, apart from obviously cleaning up the disgrace that it was before, was to be able to, for any future videos that I do shoot, point the camera in any direction and for the backdrop and the background to still be interesting. So I feel like I've done a good job. I'm hoping that you think so too. I'm gonna start bringing a lot of the stuff back into the room and adding the finishing and the final touches. And I look forward to showing you the final product.